Earthly people will pay me for my work. How much more a holy God of Israel? I have suffered. I deserve my pay. And in Galatians 7, he said, yes, let no man trouble me. He said, let no man trouble me because of what? Because I'm blessed of the Lord. Because I have money to spend. Because I am a powerful man. Because I'm an apostle, I can see things. Because God revealed things to me. That I don't want to trouble me. No. He said, Lord, let no man trouble me. Because I have scar on my body. I have scar to prove that I belong to God. I have suffered for the Lord. I have worked laboriously for the kingdom. So I deserve. And in Philippians 2:8-9, he said, Jesus, God in every way, yet he humbled himself and died a shameful death. And because of that pain and suffering, the Lord God has exalted him and given him a name that is above every other name. And at the mention of the great name Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven, things on earth, and things underneath, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Because of his pain, because of his challenges. So when we go through pain, we will wear that crown of glory, because we must wear the crown of thorn, the crown of pain, because we will wear that crown. Jesus said, don't you know I have to go through this pain before I enter into my glory? He said, I have to wear the crown of thorn before they will give me that crown of glory. And Philippians says that he is seated at the right hand side of God, not because he's the Son of God, not because he's divine, but he seated there because he humbled himself and died a shameful death. You now see why Christians go through challenges and difficulties. You now know why you have the problems you have. God will leave something that will always cause you to pray, that will always cause you to come to him, because he knows the heart of man. It's so ungrateful if God does it all for us. God can solve our problem in 2 seconds. That you live here and whatever money you need will come. Children will come. You have everything. But he knows that when he blesses children, they forget about him. That is why when the Israelites in Exodus, they were living, God told Moses, he said, when you have gotten to Canaan and you are blessed, please don't forget me. Because God knew that once they are blessed and they are comfortable, what will they do? They'll forget about God. That's why I preach on this platform and say that if you were to get 100 million right now, very few will come to this prayer meeting, this platform. If you have $100 million, if you have servants, if you have Rolls Royces, if you have planes and jets, and you speak and people tremble, and you have audience with the president and American president and great men, you will never, never, never come to this platform to pray for the salvation of your soul. Never. You see? Are you understanding my point, the gist of the message I'm sending to you? Mm-hmm. If you have $100 million, that is when God will know whether you are truly for him or not. If you have 100 million euros, 100 million in your bank account, it will change your heart. It will change your mind. It will change your perception. And you, the things of God will have very little meaning to you. Very little. That's why James, he said, the rich exploit the poor. So salvation is actually for the poor man. They are the ones God cares for. Because they are the ones that are being exploited and suffering. Lazarus, you remember the first Lazarus? He said, he told a rich man that you had your fill, you enjoyed, and now you are suffering. Lazarus in the world was suffering. And so now he has come to a place of joy. So when we suffer, we should take it and ask God, what do I need to learn from this? Yes, there's a difference between suffering and also suffering because of sin or because some power is sitting on your destiny. Satan also attacks the Christians. Yes, that's why we pray. Satan also does that. God never, never will put you through pain. God will never, never. But if you sin and pain come, God will not take you out. He will let you go through. Yes. That is why we need to pray. God didn't take Jesus from the pain of the cross. No, he let him go through. God didn't take Job from pain, suffering. He handed him into the hand of Satan. He said, don't take his soul. So our own sin has put us into troubles and challenges. We should never blame God. We should just continue to pray. We pray for his will to be done. We pray that Satan will not put something on you. We pray that Satan will not kill you before his time, because he also does bad things to us, Satan. But God will never stop him. Yes, God will never stop him. Yes, most of the cases, there are certain things God will not stop Satan. Yes, did he stop Satan from attacking Paul? No. Did he stop Satan from attacking Paul? He said, my grace is sufficient enough for you. Surely. So when you are weak, that's when I am strong. You see? So Satan attacked Paul, and Paul was very weak. Because when Paul felt weak, he humbled himself. When you are weak, you humble yourself. Well, you always have to pray to God before things will, you have a level, your pain will reduce a little. You will always come. God will sit on your papers to draw your attention. God will put some pain in some part of your body. God will attack your finances just so he will draw your attention. Because if he doesn't do that, man will not come. He told the Israelites, when you are comfortable in Israel, please, and in Cana, where you are going, don't forget me. Because God knew that once they get there and he blessed them and they are comfortable, the first thing they will do is to forget him. And lo and behold, once they got to Cana, God gave them the strength to conquer the lands around him, and they settled and have money. What did they do? They followed the idols of Philistines and sacrificed their children to Baal or Baal, whatever, and forgot about God, who has provided for them, supported them, and blessed them, and given them the land flowing with milk and honey. They forgot about him. So this is a secret I'm telling you. It's a pure, raw message of the that's time. Many pastors will never touch on this. They say, God bless you, God bless you. No, suffering is actually, well, God gets glory. That's why he put us through pain. That's why he humbled the believer. That's why very, very few people who truly serve God are very, very, very rich. Few. Especially at least the few. I dare to say that even maybe, and it's debatable that some people can disagree, but if you were to preach the true gospel message, you can never have more than 10,000 people in your church. I'm telling you. So how can you make some no credit give me? Now, cassette ya bonnet. Oh, cassa se crunku ye. Oh, cassa se nipa fan huma foria et so. Now, on ya crunkume radinum cumi honi papa. All trans as you me as empa. Now, quite a nimma fata. And a mobile to me as in your can. Well, this is in tea in a me fan. Now, we also know to a puppy who preach about salvation of our soul. You are preaching about death of the cross, brokenness, pain, and repentance. You will never get 10,000 people in your church. I'm telling you. You even 1,000 crowns. I'm telling you. Here, and it's debatable, and I stand for correction.
It's true.
I'm telling you. Yes. When the church collapses, the reason, because God doesn't control the will of people, but Satan is cantankerous, he's bad, and you force him to control the will of people. And you will be out can cry wasra, I'm telling you, what the mother in Shano of a man would be, was it Apostle Man? I bought it. I bought rejects. Now, what you are, you are in the church and your pastor is saying he bought rejects. He said he wants the pandemic to continue. He wants the pandemic to continue so people will die, because in the pandemic he has bought rejects. Can you imagine? Think about how some people, think about people who are suffering. Think about people who have lost their work. Those who are dying, You said the Lord has blessed you even in the pandemic. You have bought a jet, so you want it to continue so that you get money. Regardless of those who are dying. Did God bless you to sit on it, or God bless you to be a blessing? Why do you need a three jet if you are not evangelist? Why? It doesn't make sense.
I don't know. Friday, I bet Basil, because I heard of a Samakan.
Yes. It's so sad. And it's not the, okay. Not a blessing, but you are boasting that God has blessed you of all this thing. All this thing. But God blesses you. So we are going to digress. So it is only in pain and suffering that many of us come to Christ. It's not because God shouldn't bless us. I'm not saying that. But like he blessed John Wesley when he came to serve him. But God knew the heart. So the man gave everything. He said, when God has blessed him, he will be greedy. He will want more and more. And he doesn't want that. So the only means to cure that is he's just going to give everything away. He will be comfortable. He'll have a room to stay, a place to sleep. But he doesn't want to live ostentatious life when he knows that others are suffering. When you know that some people are in hospital sick, they can't even pay their hospital bill. He's not going to be comfortable seeing that somebody is walking around with 100 million and he's a man of God. No. He will bless you to be a blessing. And so we are going to quickly go through this and then we'll begin to pray. So we say, why does God allow? So because they keep us from being attracted to the things of this world. God doesn't want us to live for the things of this world because the joy of this earth will grow dim. And their glories, they will pass away. So God sometimes keeps us through challenges so that we will always be closer to him because we need him for help. We need him more and more to assist us. Yes. And God also put us through challenges because it keeps us from praying to him all the time. In James says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. When a righteous man is praying, his prayer is very fervent. That is why when you fast, your prayer is powerful because you have crucified the flesh. And when we eat, we are very comfortable. You pray and something is, you are thinking about something else. You see, what did you have me out bumping out why been in a baby? Yes. Say, anytime you pray and happens like that, that means that Satan is blocking your prayers. Every time you pray, you know, it's a wife bringing in a baby. They just say, your prayer is being blocked. Why do you focus on God? Anytime you pray and your mind goes adrift somewhere, that prayer is being blocked. Yes, and also, God takes us through challenges to prove himself. Yes, that is why he didn't take Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from the fire. So that people will know that even in the fire, God can deliver. Yes, that is why he also didn't take Daniel from the lion's den. He put Daniel in the lion's den so people can know that God can even deliver you from the lion's den. That is why Jesus said here that for the glory of God. If the man didn't die for 4 days, where he was almost rotten and smelling, that God could raise him back to life. People will never give glory to God. So God did that so that they know that this God is awesome and very, very powerful. Glory. And you know that my problem, God can solve it. If he will not solve it, he will give me the grace to carry it. Mm-hmm. Yes. He'll give you the grace. You'll never die because of your troubles. You go through. One pastor said, he said, when I started the ministry, I prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed. I fasted and prayed. God never answered any of my prayers. And there are times when I wonder, even if there's God. He said, I stand in the pulpit and preach. But I wonder myself because my prayers are going unanswered. I am going through challenges. I have troubles on every side. And he said, through it all, after 30 years, I'm still standing and see where the Lord has brought me. I have nothing but gratitude. That when he didn't answer my prayers, I was wondering, God, are you really for me? Have I sinned? Have I done anything wrong? Is that why I'm going through challenges? But I didn't give up. And now look at where I am. This is where the Lord God has brought me. May his holy name be praised. When I was going through challenges, God was still walking behind me. He said, if you walk through the shadow or the valley of the shadow of death, I will be with you. God will not take you through the valley of the shadow of death. He will be with you through the fire. He walks through, he doesn't take you from the fire, but he is with you through the fire. He is with you through your pain. He is with you through your suffering. Why? Just to draw your attention. Because if he were to take you out of that pain and suffering, the next thing you know, you will not even pray to him again. By the time you pray, you'll be sleeping on your bed. You'll be lying there quietly, saying some, half-fasted prayers to him. So he will keep you on your toe through challenges, through hardship. That is why Christian goes through hardship. That's why he allowed us to suffer sometimes. And also, God allows problems so that we'll be disciplined. We will not be so pompous. That is our strength. That we, yes, that's what he kept Paul in difficulties, to humble the Apostle Paul, to break him down. Why? Because he will exalt himself. If you read 2 Corinthians 11, 12, he said, Paul said God showed him the heavens, the glory, things that he would not even be able to express it or even say. And some things he was told never to say. After that, what? Satan buffeted him. God didn't do anything. But God allowed him to be attacked by Satan. And he cried to God, that God, I beg you, take this pain from me. 3 times God didn't take that pain. And God knew that Paul was thinking about it. God, haven't I suffered enough? Why am I still suffering? So God revealed to him that, Paul, when you are weak and when you are going through pain, that's when my glory and my power is strong on you. But when you are comfortable and you are blessed, you will not see my power in you. You begin to think it's your own strength. That is why my glory is made perfect in your weakness. So I'm not saying that we should take every pain and suffering and say this is the will of God. No. Ask God, Father, what do I need to learn from the challenges I'm going through? Don't abandon God because of your troubles. Because God can solve them. He is showing you anything. Say, God, give me the grace to carry this cross. Give me the grace to make it through. Give me the grace to finish and finish well, is what I'm praying. So we pray that if there's any power attacking us, because Satan also take advantage and will attack you, not because you have done anything wrong, just because you are a Christian. Those that are in the world, he will leave them alone, by Christians especially. You don't want Satan to attack you because you don't pray. You don't want Satan to attack you when it's not really the will of God. This is why we pray. Because he attacks Christians. All being attacked left and right. Send a baby out. You want to say, we did it. Because we're seeing you were the right way. And you know, we're attacked. Anything that Paul suffered, that's why James suffered. That's why John the Baptist, they cut off his head. Where was God when they cut off John's Baptist? God is still on his throne. Not that's what it was. Also, for Uncle said, we're pretty come as Shankrofin grind. He has encouraged people. Then the next Sunday, Saturday, his son was praying and he crossed the street and a car hit him. And he died. The pastor said, no, I'm not going to go to church. I won't send the Lord. How can my son? But then the elder of the church went to him and said, Pastor, were you not the one that the church member died and you said that he should give glory? God knows everything. He said, I want God to answer me. Where was he when my car hit my son? And the elder told him that God was sitting on his throne. Where he was sitting on his throne when his son Jesus died. He was still sitting on that throne when your son died. When pastor heard that, he picked up his Bible. No, quite sorry. or see maybe I met here you couldn't buy you so what or thing that was one kind of bone. Yes. When pastor heard that he picked up that Bible, he said, I'll go to church. It can happen to Geese, it can happen to Ganda. Jesus said, carry that cross and follow me. Yes. So you heard it. It's a long message, but we want to cut it short because we want to have time also to pray. And Jesus said, for the glory of God. The question to you and I is, why is it that the glory of God was not a blessing? That Jesus would say, I have blessing for my glory, but always for his pain. Why is it that Jesus didn't get a name above every other name because he's the Son of God? That he's all powerful and mighty. But they gave him that name when he humbled himself and died a shameful death on the cross. Why is it that Paul didn't say, God, let no man trouble me because God has blessed me. He has opened my eye to see wonderful things. I'm a powerful apostle. But he said, let no man trouble me, even Satan himself. Why? Because I have scar for the Lord. Me when you meet, I have suffered for him. No one can trouble me. No one can mess me. Even demons will run. Satan himself will never mess with him because he knows I've suffered for the Lord. It's not because Satan will not mess with you because you are blessed of the Lord. No, you are. He is not afraid of you at all. If you have money and you are blessed, he is afraid of you. If you are hungry, if you are fasting, if you are on your knees praying and bombarding the heavenly spirit because of challenges, he is afraid. He's never afraid when you are comfortable and full. You see why Christians sometimes go through challenges. So when that happens, please give God glory. And say, Father, give me the grace to stand like the apostle. Through it all, he stood. And he said, I've fought a good fight. Father, give me the grace that in spite of all my challenges, I will never stop praying. But if problems persist, I will give you glory. And I will say, Father, let your will be done. Just like Mary, we're going to pray. He said, let your will be done. The angel came, he said, you are going to give birth. He didn't say, I'm a virgin. How can this happen? He said, Father. He said, let it be unto me according to your will. Mary. And when Jesus was on the cross, he said, Father, if I have to drink this cup, this bitter cup of redemption, and there's no other way, Father, your will be done. You know, Mary also said, let it be unto me. Yes, according to your will. She didn't understand God. How can I give birth? I've never met a man before. I'm a virgin. I've never even had sex before. How can you tell me I'm going to give birth? But he said, let it be unto me according to your will. That is faith. He didn't say, But when he went to Zechariah, a prophet of God, he said, how can these things be? How can this be? I am 84 years. It cannot be. You see, the prophet of God himself was doubting. But the little girl said, let it be unto me according to your will. And Jesus on the cross, he said, Father, if this cup cannot be taken, but I have to pass through, Father God, thy will be done. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
When we go through challenges after praying and praying, we say, God, let your will be done. But give me the grace to stand and never deny you. We are going to stand and we're going to pray.
Daddy, we patch your media, same be firm. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Daddy, me patch. And run a minute with Dean Commano.
You.
You Dean Commano, you know.
Yeah.
Dear me, who you are, sir, and where children and I do not me die and I dear Bachin, no. You know, we said my bow fee.
Yes.
Now me bow fee, no. Me, we saw you in a kitchen, not kitchen, no. I do any baby, see, we stove, no, so. I will have the kitchen way neat. And it be now me present come with them. But why am I requiring my man? But only me didn't come on. Only me didn't come on 1-2 and what be a chance. And so now doing somebody, I never come no carry. Now I saw Baba Casa my home. And it's why my man with them. And it's Mimi Winnie, he said. I did, and Mimi Winnie said, and come on, I mean, you did, you know. I wouldn't get serious ever home. And it's Miss Row when you mean him, Daddy. Miss Row, me power chill be brave. Send your macumba sit down to honor. Macumba do be beachy. And it's Miss Row, said the radius here be a short terminal. Now, Samuni, sir, a dear num now avoid me. Now, what did me me wura ma ha ti me sraw ye serious wa sam no because nyame any hwa me nu me nu wo
you me di ho sraw pa amisha me di ho juma I am pana me decided to crank am in ye but
and go na because me wuni sa aduane no kwan when he was wo ana da di aduane no so say eh sana tie so at aduane so kura because woni me kasa 1-2 no wa kan hwe.
Yeah.
Only because I want to know, I can ask when you serious word, me home, and an amuse of who avoid them. One person will am John Passima Bassemin.
You, why baby I'm back? We are I don't know what I'm gonna be about fight about food.
We
want to cut down on food. Because me and Kasa me to a mini tyrant. It's a dream you have me yak and say and so still have me. Because well me tyrant yeah in see this was when I was in the world. Now me soon I'm crying, I'm in the US here, eat the US yet and we use our tyrant. And see, a mommy gaining weight in a bad. And it's not mommy tea pie, now come with me, but tarot to no mommy tea pie, me tea upper. And as I saw, I'm gaining weight. And he just said, particularly, I am you be as I'm coming to cry because make me fast 7 days cry, I meant your home. But be honest, so once you are media, this is your cousin, so I continue to eat. And you know, crepa, and I'm the more if you come once. And crepa, you said, if you know Binami part. And as I'm saying, initial Nanka being show interest, but me whip my friend, me bad naming in a casa.
Yes.
Thank you, prophet. Now we're going to thank the Lord. Thank him, sir. He has preserved us through thick and thin, through challenges and difficulties. We are going to thank him, sir. May the Lord sustain us, no matter the challenges we face. That it will not cause us to give up. And it will not cause us to die. It will not cause our enemies to laugh us. That, Father, we thank you that you are preserving us. May the Lord preserve you through the challenges. Thank you that the Lord will sustain you. I don't know what your troubles are. I don't know the challenges and difficulties you face. But I know that God will see you through. So long as you keep praying. So thank the Lord, that, Father, thank you for preserving my life. Thank you for how far you have brought me. Father, I give thanks to you for everything. I commit my ways to you, good or bad. I give them to you so that Jehovah, you will sustain me in the name of Jesus.
Let you
I'm going to go to the hospital. before his because I am enjoying my life.
Amen.
I know that when we say thank you, the prayer you don't feel the fire, but we ought to give thanks to the Lord. We ought to, no matter what, because Bible says in Thessalonians that this is His will. First Thessalonians, that is His will in Christ Jesus concerning you, the believer. So you give thanks not because you don't have problems. You give thanks not because things are good, You give thanks just because He's God. You give thanks because He's in control of your life.
Yes.
So when we are giving thanks, we give thanks to God for who He is. I know we have challenges. You have your challenge. I have my challenge. Everyone has issues. Some issues are greater than others. But God is in control. So give thanks every day to Him. That, Father, I thank you that I have roof over my head. I thank you that I have a place to go through. And remember, some people are homeless. Some people, as I speak, they have suffered COVID and are hospital. Some people, they need to tend them before they can move. Yes, I want to hospital. Because some people, you need to tend them. They lay at one place unless somebody can move. Somebody will pee on themselves. Somebody are in Pampers. And by God's grace, some people are blind. They can't even see. Some people have lost their two legs of diabetes. But by His grace, you are alive and living. You ought to give thanks just because of who He is. Thank Him because you know the Lord. Many people are rich, but they don't know Him. Many people have everything they need, but they will never be able to come and pray. A man who comes to pray has been delivered to some degree. Many people will never pray. Even people that I know, I invite them. They never come because some power has hindered them. So if you're on this platform to pray, give thanks for everything. Yes, even when times are bad, give thanks to Him and bless His holy name. For God is in control and nothing is too difficult for Him. Amen. We're going to pray again. That, yes, the prayer yesterday, we're going to pray some. The spirit controlling man. There are spirit controlling us. We are not free. It's very, very true. We have spirit of obesity, spirit of gluttony, lust, unforgiveness, bitterness. And it's very important because one spirit can take you to hell. Spirit of unforgiveness. It doesn't matter how hard you pray. One spirit of unforgiveness can take you to hell. One spirit of bitterness can take you to hell. Yes, one spirit of lust can take you to hell. One spirit of covetousness can take you to hell. Yes, one spirit of a person who is bitter and will not give gratitude to God. A person who will never forgive anything. A person who is not, doesn't show gratitude. One spirit, though, is all it takes. Lust can take you to hell. When we talk about lust, it's not only sex. Lust for you. Lust for financial gain. Lust for money. Lust for worldly things. Carnality. All this, one spirit, it takes you to hell. It's serious. Regardless of who you are, regardless of how well you pray, one spirit of greediness can take. James said, a greedy person's life is serving a different God. So we are going to pray with all seriousness against any spirit that Satan has put in us, or any spirit that has come upon us because of sin or because of things that we have desired. Okay. Remember, Jesus cast seven spirits from man. She was with Jesus. And look, her 2,000 demons from one person. Don't tell me you don't have weakness. Everyone has shortcomings. Yours could be a bitterness. Yours, some could be unforgiveness. Some could be evil thoughts. Some could be doubt. Some of us worry. Some of us anger. Some of us overeating. Some of us bitterness. Don't tell me you don't have weakness. Some of us could be pain, sickness. It's a demon. Whether it's through heart attack, it's demon, pain. Let's go to God. We are going to pray that, Father, our body is your temple. And your word said your spirit dwells in this temple. And your spirit cannot dwell with any spirit that is not of you. Bible says, what communion has light with darkness? Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father God, I shall stand and pray and cry. Any spirit control my life by the authority in the name of Jesus Christ and by the speakings of the blood. Any spirit, no matter how long you have run this one, I command you in the name of Jesus, come out of all your roots and return to me no more, that my body will be sanctified, a vessel for the use of the Almighty God. Pray against any spirit control our lives. Begin to pray, begin to pray, begin to pray. God,
I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to be able to do that. I'm not going to
You know, Galatians 5 talking about the spirit. We know that love is a spirit, joy is a spirit, hate is also a spirit. Yes, anger is a spirit, bitterness is a spirit, worry, all those infirmities are spirit. Even hell and death is a spirit that they can assign it to you. You will live on here on earth and enjoy life, but no matter what, you will go to hell. They can assign that to you. Somebody, they can assign limitation. No matter what you do, you are limited. No matter what. Yes. And so praying about this spirit, they are very powerful. And you have to pray it with all seriousness. We're going to pray again that every door that the enemy has closed, you open door. You open them by fire. You open doors of favor, doors of healing, doors of salvation, doors of empowerment, doors of favor. Divine favor will locate you. Yes, it is also part it's not only just because I preach about suffering doesn't mean, oh, I have to suffer my life. Oh, yes, God can bless you too. It is his will. Favor can locate you. Healing shall also locate you. His joy shall locate you. His purposes shall locate you. Yes. So pray that Father God, let your joy be my portion. Open doors of favor, doors of healing, doors of peace. Yes. Doors of power. Doors of peace. All that comes with all of you in the name of
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus, the Lord, 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 the L
Jesus Christ.
Jabez prayed, I think, first Chronicles or second, Jabez prayed. He went to God and said, God, enlarge my people. And Bible say what? And bless me indeed. Jabez, and you know Jacob too, when he struggled with God, he said, if you don't bless me, you don't go. Apaniel. And God said, what is your name? And he said, my name is Jacob. From this day forward, they will not call. Your name is what? Jacob the Panther. And I see, but God said, and your name is Israel. Israel, your name. Oh, don't know. You know God changed the name of Abraham. Abraham is God. God said, no. Now you are going to be the son of nations. I will call you Abraham. You know Sarai. Sarai was the wife of Abraham. She couldn't give birth. God changed her name to Sarah. Names, like the prophet said, is so powerful. There's a reason why Jesus' name was given. He said, your body different than your own. His name was given. Don't if you carry it, you cannot break it. Yes. So you are going to call. Say, Father, if you call my name, let the blood of pray yesterday. In that name. Just like you take the name of Jacob into Israel. You take the name of Abraham into Abraham. You take the name of Allah into Sarah. And make and pour your blessings and bless and my heaven. It is his will. Yeah, that is it. And when you are, don't just sit up and say, I have. But say, I have blessed. I have built orphanage for people. This is what. Cry out to the Lord. The Lord will favor you. The Lord will make a way for you. The Lord will establish you. And the Lord will plant you on a solid ground. It is not only pain and suffering. Package of goodwill is also part of it. It's good and bad. Yes. God who caused the rain also brought the sun. God who caused death also brought healing. And so open your mouth and pray. Like Jabez did. Say, Father, yes, I stand as far my territories and bless me indeed. If my name is a curse, if you cannot write the name in the book of God, Father,
I'm going to go to the hospital. Jesus Christ, you my God and my God. Thank you for abounding grace. Thank you for redeeming love. The mighty name of Jesus Christ, great God of heaven. All the things you have done, thank you for your mercy shall abound to us. The name of Jesus. Thank you, my Lord and my God. In the name of Jesus Christ, you great God of heaven. Thank you, mighty God. In the name of Jesus, mighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
In Jesus, mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. What a savior. We're going to pray prayer of intercession. Praying for helpless, praying for the needy, praying for those who are bound, praying for families and children together in the name of Jesus. Like I said, God changed it. Jabez was given a bad name and God changed it. May Jehovah change your name. As God changed the name of Sarah, you know that God changed the name of Sarah and Sarah and Jacob's name was changed into Israel. Yeah. Yes. So the Lord will do for you in Jesus' name. Now we pray for intercessory prayer. Pray for families. Pray for children. Pray for all and sundry. Pray for America. Pray for Ghana. Pray for those who have been stricken with this pandemic. And thank God that it will never come to you and your family. It shall not come near you. The Lord will mark you with the blood of Jesus. Only with your eyes you will see. But it will never come near the main. So pray for the helpers, the bound, the needy. Pray for enemies, those who fight for our day. And the Lord give them a heart for the people and be saved.
Oh God, the enemies of the Lord Jesus Christ.
eat. God, we lift us up. We lift our hands and thank you.
I cast it out, and that we have seen. Have mercy upon the world.
We have seen the adoption. Jehovah, have mercy upon us. Mercy upon the world. It's our prayer that we pray for the leaders. We pray that the leaders will put our politicians to the right. We pray that they will be spent justice in the courts, in the fortress of power. They will be spent justice, we pray, in the fortress of power. And that holiness and righteousness will grow up. Over your name, the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank you, King God of Heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Our last prayer, we pray for Pillar of Crowd, and we lift up prophet and all on this platform in the blood, that Jehovah will do something new in the lives of each and everyone. We should pray for each other. Jesus told Peter that Satan has asked to sift you like wheat, but I have prayed for you that your strength will not fail. And when you are strengthened, pray for your brethren. So it is good that this platform, you pray for others. Don't just pray together and leave on your own. Pray for the prophet. Pray for me. Pray for everyone on this platform. And as you do that, the Lord will touch you. Let's leave this platform to the Lord in prayer. That fire will come with you. And that God
will be with you. And that those who are In the name of Jesus, deliver from the power of sickness, 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 de